broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in.
The following broadcast is an official production of the Faulkner Sports Network.
Oh, and takes the kill right there. Now there's only one guy left. He knows exactly where he is. Throws grenade. Nice! Excellent.
Yes.
Dish gonna try to slip around the back here. Oh, gets one. And a second.
Round down.
Really?
Yeah, just down to Will, who's the only one left.
Think we got
all right, takes two
kills.
Three.
Wow.
It's all down to Brandon and Cole now. Fires at one guy coming off of balcony. Gets one kill. Oh my gosh, the long range headshot with the pistol. Looks like CornPop's trying to set up a long shot here, but doesn't even have op. He's just got a rifle. Oh, wow! And does. What a shot.
The equivalent of Molly counter-tears. Oh, nice read on that first
nice.
Pick. And the second.
Nice.
Sports Network.
Yeah, thank you for that. I will be your. We've had a long day, but we're going to be going into another round of CS2 in quite a minute. We are going to be going against. Help me out here, buddy.
It's French, so I'm definitely going to say this wrong. It's École de Technologie Supérieure.
Yeah.
But it essentially means School of Superior Technology.
Yeah. It was very complicated to try and pronounce. But yeah, we tried our hardest. We did an effort. And, we're going to be facing them tonight in Counter-Strike 2. And we're going to be doing hopefully really well. We got off a really good game last time. We got really close.
We did. We got really close last game. Okay. And we've got Antonio back for this week. So we'll be doing... even better now that we have an actual player and not a sub.
Poor coach. He's an actual player. But yeah, this is actually going to be, I believe, is going to be at least Antonio's first debut on the CS2 streams. So I'm hopeful that he's going to be on point in this game, and I'm very excited to see how he manages to do. We're going to try and run some player intros real quick before the game starts, and then we'll get right into the game, hopefully.
On AWP, the captain, CornPop, Cole Armstrong.
Oh, there's the captain.
Support, it's Creed, Creed Spivey. Support. It's Creed. Creed Spivey.
There's Creed again.
Name's so nice, I had to say it twice, apparently.
The entry fragger, SuperDish, Brendan Dishmon.
Yeah, that's the team tonight. I don't think we have a player intro for Antonio.
Yeah, we're missing one for Antonio and for Leo. Neither of them were able to get one recorded when we had them set up.
But yeah, we're going to take a look real quick into the arena real quick and see if we can get a good view. I believe that right there is going to be CornPop in the middle. And yeah, production guy can take a little bit of a stroll around, and that I believe is going to be Leo. I'm going to apologize for us right now. We're kind of running on a scuffed setup. We had a few last minute errors on our half. So we're looking at a really small screen right now. But yeah. That is Leo right there, and it looks like he is locked in and ready to play.
I don't think you're looking at the right one.
Oh, I'm not looking at... You're right. I'm not looking at the right one. My bad. Yeah, that is... In the top left, that is going to be Dish. Middle is going to be... that is Antonio right there.
That's Antonio.
Yeah, that's the first time we're actually seeing him on the stream.
It is.
Man, it's a long time coming. And that there is right there.
And yeah, in the bottom right corner there, that's ItsCreed.
ItsCreed, Mr. Spivey himself. Yeah, and today we're going to be really pumped to see a really good game.
We are. On the left over there is Leo. And on the right is the Captain CornPop, or Cole Armstrong.
I can't believe I got that far into that, and your kid did not even stop me. it's funny. But yeah, we're trying to get another victory. I was talking to Creed earlier, actually. He sounds super excited about this game. He also sounds a little bit hungry, so he's good. He's going to be wrapping
this up. Yeah, he'll be hoping to get out of there real fast so we can go and eat.
Yeah, you already know. So it looks like we're trying to try and get into a game right now. I'm not sure if we've got an ID code sent to us yet. But
no, I think they're still talking to the other team right now.
Gotcha.
Maybe they're... I think Leo's running the antivirus.
Gotcha. Very cool.
The anti-cheat.
Yeah. Yeah, same thing. You can tell we're not computer science majors over here, guys. But yeah, the teams look very, very confident this turn around.
This time around?
What did I say?
Turn.
Ah, you're right. But yeah, we're going to be trying to get a really good win, and the teams look very stacked. I'm not sure exactly how good this school that we're facing is going to be, but I don't think we've actually faced them yet.
No, we've never faced this school before.
So it's going to be very interesting, because it's one of those kind of schools we don't have any kind of information about. It's kind of like when you try to gather like information on like who you're trying to fight, and it's like there's nothing there, so we're just gonna try and make the best of it, you know. While we wait, I want to talk to you guys real quick about some of the interesting stuff that's been happening. We had yesterday was a production first ever for Faulkner. We had our first win in Smash Bros, and the Smash Bros team is coming off a mega high right there. We are super excited, and everyone on that team is super ecstatic about winning. What are your thoughts on that?
I was there last night. We won the Smash game, the first one that Faulkner Esports has ever won since it was started up, and that was super exciting to be a part of.
Oh yeah, I know that there's not really a certain name for positions on Smash Bros, but we're gonna give you one for that one. How did it feel to be anchor for most of the fight there?
It felt like there was a good deal of pressure on me to try and clutch up in the end. I was able to take it in the first round, but in the second round I couldn't finish him off.
Yeah. So for any viewers who are out there and have not seen that game, it is a definitely must watch.
Yes, you must go watch that game, because it's a nail biter.
Yeah, action packed and full of suspense. Love to see it. But for now, let's kind of focus a little more on CS2. What do you think is going to be one of the major things that they've worked on since the last game?
I think team coordination is key, and now that they've got someone that's been on the team,
this is Antonio's first semester.
This is Antonio's first semester, I'm sure he has lots of game knowledge, because I haven't played Counter-Strike with him. I haven't talked to him a whole lot outside of one of our classes together. I'm not sure exactly what his play style is or how well he functions with the team, but we'll find that out tonight, and we can hope that he'll do better than Coach did, and Coach did pretty good while he was holding his spot.
Oh, yeah. Dare I even say he had some highlight-worthy plays in there, too,
yeah,
honestly.
I think he did.
Like, the man was going crazy sometimes, but honestly, just the amount of, like, sheer, like, clutch plays that were made on both sides. Yeah. Faulkner and I don't not remember, was it South Carolina? I think that's who we fought that time.
It maybe. I don't remember who it was. We don't have the papers up here anymore.
Yeah, it is what it is. But yeah, I think we have a really good chance that we're gonna have a more of a coordinated team. I mean, coach is very coordinated with the boys, but now that we have an actual in practice team member, I'm not sure if coach does a whole lot of CS2 practices, but yeah, it's definitely gonna be a lot more cohesive now, I do believe.
Yeah.
At least we hope. At least we hope. I'm not sure if we really know the names of the maps, but what is like the best one that you think that Faulkner really plays on?
I think I heard coach talk about one, Vertigo, which is the map that takes place in the building that looks like it's being rebuilt or maybe torn down. He said that's one they practice on a lot, and that's one they've gotten pretty good at. That's really the only one that I can think of with the name, at least. Another one is the one that's kind that looks like it's in the Midwest, not Midwest, the Middle East, with the stone and sand buildings. I think he said they practiced on that one a good bit as well. And then there's the one in the desert that they haven't practiced on very much at all. It's got, I don't even know how to describe it now, but it's got kind of a red color palette and lots of, it's a pretty big map though.
Yeah. One of the things I've actually kind of noticed in my short time commentating for the the CS2 games is that there is a lot of interesting things that the Faulkner team does when it comes to certain maps, because they tend to have a more of a nice advantage when it comes to certain stages. Like whenever you have like really like open hallways or like open spots in a area, they tend to do fairly well. And there's not a lot of open spots in CS2. But whenever we do like come across like a hallway or something like that, that's kind of like bare bones, there's not much cover, we can just like pop in and take a kill or two.
Yeah, one of the things about open hallways in CS2 is most of the time it comes down to who's quicker on the draw and who can get closer to the head on shooting. And fortunately, we've been pretty consistent at pulling those off in our recent games. Dish has also done really good at the corridor ones where they come in and he hammers at them with the gun he uses,
the Negev.
Yeah, the Negev.
That's such an awesome weapon.
The LMG.
Yeah. It's so good. It's just a showstopper. You know, like he just sits there. I mean, he doesn't really sit there, but he tactically maneuvers himself into positions where he just is just in really an advantageous spot. You know, yeah. And that's what we saw last game in one of those clips that I just loved. I'd go back and watch that again if I could and just see.
We could. Man,
that was a really good play because there was, I think he got three kills in that.
He got three in that, and then later in the mat, in the round, he killed another person before the bomb.
That's almost an ace right there. And yeah, that's beautiful, especially from a player using such a sporadic gun.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the Negev is not like any means of the definition of accurate.
No,
it's just one of those spray and pray weapons.
Exactly what it is. It's a spray and pray weapon.
And it's just definitely the weapon that kind of defines the playstyle of our boy Dish, because he's got that kind of personality that was like, he can be accurate when he wants to be, but he prefers to be kind of a loose cannon.
Mm-hmm.
And it's awesome because it's just the way he plays. And I like getting kind of inspired by him every single time I play. Like I watch him play. But then you've got other people on the team who like do such crazy things. Like, I think one of my funniest favorite parts of last game was when CornPop was in pissed around with dualies.
Oh yeah, I don't remember how many. Did he kill three or four?
I don't remember. I think it's three or four sounds about right.
Yeah, that was. Oh man, that was such a good thing. Are we getting into game, Mike?
Hashtag yeah, play Mike.
No, he can't control this one.
I'm just messing with
it. I think they're still running the anti-cheat. They're trying to get into it. But that was such a good play by CornPop with the dual wielding the pistols.
Oh, yeah. Always kind of that finesse like kills, you know, like him just showing off, like spinning around the pistols at the end of every kill, like it's just a little bit toxic, but just the right amount of toxic to be cool enough, you know. And that there's the captain for you, you know he's got to have that little bit of finesse or style, you know, just something to personalize it, you know. I feel like that's something that almost every single lieutenant or captain has. It's just a little bit of unique something they add to the team, you know. And for Call of Duty, my brain is absolutely done today.
Counter-Strike 2.
Goodness, it's been a long day.
All right, it looks like they just sent Mike the IP. Is that right?
Yep.
All right.
So we will be on a 2-minute delay, so we have to wait a little bit. But while we wait, we can still kind of talk a little bit more about said team. What are you expecting? We haven't really talked a lot about this, especially on the stream. What are you expecting a little bit more from Leo this time? Because he's brand new.
I mean, he's been doing really good from what we've seen on the games. He's able to consistently get... Oh, I don't know if I'd say consistently... Fairly often, he's able to get 2 kills before he goes down. Sometimes it's there's a trade-off, and Leo's usually the trade, which isn't great for us, but I don't know.
I mean, I don't think
at least he's able to get the kill before he goes down.
I don't think I've ever seen him run a negative KD
in this game. No, never. So
that's something very impressive, especially for this game, because like negative KDs are something that kind of bites a little bit.
Yeah.
And I've never seen most of the players on Faulkner actually have one. So I mean that's good props for them, you know, because they're keeping on the grind of the aim training and the positional awareness of where they are and where they think they can't know for certain, but where they think the people are going to be.
Yeah.
And I think we're going to see a lot more interesting things happen in this game. Just based on the amount of practice I've seen from the said team, because like they're probably I don't want to say dedicated, because they're pretty dedicated, but they don't have as much practice hours as some of the other games.
Yeah,
that's what I'm gonna say. But we still gonna see a lot tonight. I do believe. All right, it does look like we're trying to get into a game. There we go. It looks like we're in a warm-up round. I'm not sure if we can run this or not, but looks like our producer is having a fun time over there. So we'll be getting on that soon. But one of the things that I think is going to be very interesting in this game is just, honestly, gun selection. Because that's one of the big things in this game is balancing your econ along with what guns you're going to use. And look, there we are.
All right.
A warm-up match, I believe.
And we've got game audio.
Heck yeah.
So it does look like this is just warm-up round. They're messing around, you can see.
Yep. Who is that? I cannot tell.
That looks like Dish.
Very cool.
I don't know, it is very hard to read the names. So, what are you expecting from Overwatch next week?
Overwatch, honestly, from White Team, I'm expecting a lot more practice. So I am the lieutenant of the Smash Bros. Team, which means I am the captain of White Team, which means I do make a lot of the, if not all of the shots for White Team.
I said Overwatch.
Overwatch, oh. Bro, I'm actually dead. Like, I need to go take a nap. It's too late in the day for me to be talking.
You probably should have done that earlier.
So, Overwatch is gonna be, they have a stream on Tuesday. Honestly, I'm expecting a lot of things. They've been working on a different kind of team comp.
They have. They've been running a new team composition.
It's infuriating, but also kind of good.
Yeah, like, it's pretty good.
It's a little bit different, and I'm not sure how I necessarily feel about playing against it, but the fact that I'm mad when I play against it means it's gonna be good
when they ran it on us, I was able to get a few picks on Ian every now and then, and I know for a fact it just made him absolutely furious. But who was it, Robert, that was playing the Sombra?
Yeah,
she was just able to clean me up every time.
All All right, looks like we're getting really close to getting in. You can kind of hear that timer going on. Yeah, we'll be in just a second. All right, and it looks like we are in, I believe this is going to be knife round. I'm trying to say to decide who's going to be terrorist or who's going to be counter-terrorist. I think this is more of a, I think it's already pre-decided in the chat, the schools, and I do believe that, I wish I could have like a way to tell you guys, but I have no idea. So one team will kill the other one, not by skill. This is definitely not a skill thing. This is just
there is a bit of skill behind it. The skill comes from timing, and that's about it.
Well, not from that round.
The knife round?
No, because it's like a before battle etiquette, because it's deciding who goes to be counter-terrorist or terrorist. So it's like picking characters in Smash Bros. Like the first pick.
Well, the thing is, I don't know if they decided in the chat, because it kind of looked like they were fighting back. So right.
I don't know. And there goes one person.
So we've already lost two guys early on in the round.
That is unfortunate.
And this is only pistol round, so that's not great.
What even hit him with? That, like, it looked like a sniper shot, honestly.
I could not tell you what it is.
Looks like they're trying to get like a little bit over this wall with a.
Yeah, one of the little things in the game where you can jump on the back of a teammate and then get up on, I think, either the ledge or the roof right there. Alright, so it all comes down to CornPop, who's able to get one pick. He's able to get a second one before he goes down.
Man, he's a bad dude.
He is a bad dude.
He's like, you know what? You guys are going to kill me, but you know, I'm going to take you guys with me too.
That's exactly right.
So that was round one. Now it's pissed around, and it looks like we are down one. But that does not mean a whole lot in the very beginning, because things can change quite quickly.
They can.
Based on a whole lot of factors, especially econ. So it does look like the team is
all gonna... All it takes is a little bit of money to make this, to change the scale.
Is CS2 pay to win?
No, of course not.
All right,
we've already lost somebody. I think that it might have been Leo. All right, a second person goes down. And now we're just left with one person. And I do believe it's Creed. Fortunately, he's not nice. Able to pull it off.
That round. That's not good. One of the things I did see right there that we could probably work on a little bit better on is we kind of get a little bit spread out.
Yeah.
And they're able to kind of play
pick
on
us off individually.
Yeah, and that's not a good thing. So they just need to focus a little more on staying together and maybe holding each other's backs. So when one person gets killed, they kind of flip around the corner and kill the person who killed them, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So that's like, you know, someone dies, they didn't die in vain.
Yeah, so it doesn't all go to waste.
Exactly.
So they're able to get a good flank and take out two of our guys.
Yeah.
We're able to take one, but we can't get the other guy.
Unfortunately, the reload does kill him.
Yeah, so now we're left with just one person. All CornPop had was the pistols, was one pistol, and he wasn't able to do anything with it.
Yeah, unfortunate. Looks like we are off to a very steep start. Right off the bat, we're going to call it ETS. ETS starts out with really pretty steep advantage.
Yeah, a three point advantage.
Yeah, not great for Faulkner, but I've seen him come back from worse.
Yeah.
Right, looks like we're starting to get a little more spread out this time. It's not a bad thing to be spread out, but as long as they know
where each other are.
Yeah, exactly. All right. So they're coming down. They're playing a lot slower this time because they're like, we've been getting killed a little bit too fast this game. These games, let's slow it down a little bit and kind of take a different approach. Try and get a little bit more of an off angle, if you will. Very slow.
Not a whole lot happening. There's very little movement.
And it had the door kind of like locked down from either side.
Alright, so unfortunately he wasn't able to do anything about that. And we're now down three guys. We're down to our last guy. I can't tell who that is.
Counter-terrorists win.
Unfortunate. Faulkner kind of getting a little bit caught off guard, if you will. They put themselves into some positions where it's not very preferable. But also the other team just has a really, really good knowledge of what a person would do before they do it. So more of a predictive stance, which is also, it's really good, but also it can backfire real easy.
Yeah. So that was really bad. One person, it looked like, threw an incendiary grenade, and another one threw a Molotov. Unfortunately, they landed very close to each other, so if you you couldn't really step anywhere without catching on fire.
Yeah. And unfortunately,
and ETS is taking a 5-game lead. Is that what that says?
Yeah, I do believe. That's crazy. This team looks like they like know what they're doing. They have really good aim, really good battle awareness, and it's just going to be very, very difficult for Faulkner to even try and make a comeback here. They're gonna go as far as they can with this game, is, you know, but it's going to be very difficult for them to make any kind of headway.
Yeah, it is. So, a lot of people using their utilities probably to try and space out, maybe flush somebody out of their hiding spot.
All right, looks like we are down two people, which is not good.
Yeah.
But let's see what they can do right here.
Oh man, that was just a lucky. That was an unfortunate peak for us, and the other guy just happened to be coming up at the exact same time, and he was able to pull the trigger first.
Max can stand off. And unfortunately,
Now we're just down to Creed, and I can't tell who the other person is.
Yeah.
Does that say SuperDish?
I have not a clue.
Oh, Antonio?
Okay. Oh, it's Antonio.
Man.
Well, that's unfortunate.
So ETS has been able to take 6 games, and this
honestly,
is...
I think I might know why I think we're losing. This team is really, really strong on the defense. Like, extremely.
Yeah.
Like, if they don't have to push in, they'll just wait for Faulkner to push in. And then Faulkner just has to push in because they have a time limit. Mm-hmm. And if they don't do anything in this time limit, we're going to lose.
Yeah.
The moment.
And I don't know if you can see the map up there, but they have actually spread out very strategically. They have let 3 people take south and 2 people take the north.
Yeah.
And so they're dividing and conquering. Or not really dividing and conquering. They're boxing Faulkner in. And they're picking them off as they poke out.
Yeah.
So we're now down one guy. We're able to take one of theirs, but we have lost 2 more. We're able to take another one, but now it's just down to Leo. Wow.
Right.
An amazing shot by the other guy.
Goodness. It's a massacre. We're able to take a little more kills that game. So it does seem that Faulkner's starting to get a little more used to the way that ETS is playing. And it's not a great thing that it stays this long. But it's good that maybe in the second game we'll have a little bit more success with taking
lives.
Wow. So we're able to take two of theirs and only lose one of ours. So that puts us up. Yeah. Oh, man. One guy is able to take three of ours.
Holy cow.
So that leaves us with just SuperDish. He's rocking the shotgun, which is really good in close quarters. So it looks like he's about to get a good shot. Oh, yeah.
Already. Let's go.
So we're still at a disadvantage, 2-1. I don't think Dish has the bomb. He's going to have to go find it or go get it. And I think the other team might be guarding it. Because I do believe one of the three people that jumped out had the bomb.
He's taking a sweet old time, but that's beautiful. He's trying to make his way to try and get the bomb back. Let's see if he can try and do it here. He doesn't really want to go out there. I can tell.
No, they're definitely keeping an eye on him. Yeah. All right, they're going to... I think the other guy's going to hold that point over there, and this guy that we can see, but Dish can't. He's going to try and flank.
I think he saw something there that wasn't actually there.
Yeah, I think he saw the guy.
Poor Dish needs to sleep like I do. You can hear him.
Yeah. So we lose this round, but Dish is able to save his economy. He's able to keep his guns.
Still very close. He did a great job holding it as long as possible.
He did.
All right, that's actually going to help us out a lot because we have better economy now. You can see that some of us have sniper rifles even. All right, they're making their way through this little...
Ooh, wow.
I'm surprised that didn't hit.
That was a close shot.
Firing down range. Let's get them. There's one.
Right, so...
Ooh.
Wow. Their team is down... Oh. Well, I was gonna say their team is down 2, we're down 1, but now both teams are down 2. The playing field's been evened.
Oh, there's another one.
We're able to take another one of theirs.
Leaving one of our players with like 4 HP, I believe.
That says 1.
That says 1?
He is 1 hit away from dying.
That's so bad.
Is that Antonio, Mike?
That's... Yeah.
So he's living on a prayer.
That's quite literally. He's a soft breeze away from being in the grave. Yeah. I'm surprised that little jump there didn't do it.
Yeah, fortunately, just jumping off of a small patio isn't enough to kill you. And they're able to take one of ours. I think they're able to finish off Antonio.
It looks like
It looks like they're gonna try and go defuse bomb.
Hey, Antonio's still alive.
Oh,
not
man.
For long.
So CornPop's gonna try and defend the bomb, and he's not able to do it.
Well, maybe.
I think the bomb might go off. Oh no, this guy has a diffuser kit, so if he's able to find the bomb fast enough, will he be able to do it?
Oh
man, it was really close.
Very close. It looks like Faulkner's trying to start. He's starting to make a comeback a little bit.
Yeah.
They're starting to get better, more adjusted to the way they're playing, and I can see him coming back. I could actually see it. It'd take a lot.
Yeah, this will be a hard comeback to make because we are down 9 points.
Yeah.
So everybody's making their way around. We lose somebody really early there in the firefight. Oh man. So we're now down 2 people, but they're down 1. All right, we're able to take one more. Now we're just down to just Antonio.
Yeah, okay. That's a sniper. Oh, I just had a drop on him. Really bad position right there. Alright, looks like they're gonna try to go back in. I believe this is round, what, 11?
Yes, we're in round 11 right now. And it's first to 14, or 13.
Alright, and they're making their way back up this one little alley. I'm surprised they aren't using more snipers, honestly. They might not be able to afford them. Just with the way that the economy is right now. That's a lot of fire.
Yeah.
Leaving one of our guys with really low HP.
Yeah, he is down to 20. Creed's down to 12.
Not a good situation to be in, but you know, a well-placed incendiary or
really anything would finish him off at this point.
Yeah.
So a whole lot of shooting going on. Don't think anybody's killed yet.
But I like to see this, though. They're starting to move more in a group. So if one person gets hit, they have a chance to just all turn one direction.
Yeah, everyone's moving as one unit. Oh, man. Right, unfortunately, right, we go down, but we're able to take one of theirs in a trade.
Exactly.
So it keeps the playing field even. We're able to take another one of theirs.
Leaving one of our guys at 20 HP.
He goes down. So I think Antonio's going to make a mad dash and try and plant the bomb. And they're going to try and hold that point and defend it.
It's going to be a very tight defend there, but it's definitely doable.
Yeah, absolutely.
Come on, guys. You got this. Oh, unfortunately, those are a grenade at the wrong time.
Oh, man.
There, too.
Yeah, he's got a diffuser kit.
I hate to see it.
Man.
That's the true gangster.
So this is the 12th round that we're entering right now.
Yep. Just another round for the other team, and they will win if they win this one, right?
I think so.
Yeah. Ooh, barely misses that shot.
Yeah, oh man, and he gets hit. Is that through a wall?
It's one.
So we're. Three of our guys go down, and we only take one of theirs.
Two.
Oh, we do take a second.
Yep. Unfortunately, not the kind of losses we would love to see.
No. Oh, he gets a fantastic sniper shot. I'm noticing one thing these players don't tend to do very often is reload their guns when they're not in a firefight.
That's something that's a habit to most Overwatch players.
Yeah, a habit to almost any FPS shooter player. I can't think of a single game that I've played where I don't reload after just about any shot.
It's about that satisfaction, if you will.
Yeah, having a full magazine.
Yeah. Also, the reload animations are always, like, kind of sick.
Yeah. And also, it's nice to not run out of ammo in the middle of a firefight.
Ah, yes, Mr. Reaper.
Yeah. I've always said he needs two more bullets.
All right, they do the plant off, leaving the other team on two people left, and us with two people left also. There's one.
Oh, he's able to take one down.
Come on, buddy.
I think he's going to try and wall off one of his entrances with the Molotov. So CornPop is going to flank around. I think it's going to get to go off.
It's too late. It's already too late.
Oh, and we take it.
Love to see it. So apparently, the snipers are the play against this college.
Yeah, it looks like the snipers really work for us. Yeah. So everybody restarts at, well, not zero, but with pistols, and they get money. So all they can really buy right now are utilities, because it is pistol round.
Yep. Honestly, if it were up to me, I would probably save money and just go straight up knife or what is it, pistol round?
Just yeah, it's pistol round.
Yeah, just one pistol.
I don't know, unless you're CornPop and you can go dualies and drop three or four kills in the pistol round. Man.
Yeah.
They're able to take out four of our guys.
Oof. It's already over.
Yeah.
Yeah. I believe this is match point, if I'm not mistaken.
It is. It's first to 13. So, we're down 11.
Crazy.
Yeah, we'll have to make quite the team plays here for a comeback.
Even one mistake would just ruin it. But
yeah.
One.
Yeah, so we're able to get one of theirs down.
Unfortunately, he does get hit once, and it slows him down just enough for him to kind of come around the corner and kill him.
All right, nice. So he knew exactly where he was coming, and he was able to capitalize on that.
Yes,
that
sir.
Was really good.
Bomb has been planted.
Planted the bomb. We're down to two people, and they're down to three. So that puts us at a bit of a disadvantage here, but we have to do something if we want to win this.
The spray and pray. Hey,
he's able to take one down.
It works.
He's left at 18 health. Fortunately, we lose one man. So we lose that. This match.
Set. Yep.
Yep.
All right. So that brings the score for Faulkner to 0 and for ETS to 1.
One.
So, yeah, very strong start from ETS. I was not expecting such a good player or such a good player, such a good college to be playing tonight.
Yeah.
But yeah, love to see it. Love to see it. But yeah, what are the things that you think that could like make or break next round?
I think they were doing really good sticking together. However, the other teams realized they were doing that and punished them for it in a way by using AOE projectiles such as the Molotov or incendiary grenade. Something that can put down a lot of damage really fast and steadily. It's not just a one-time hit like regular hand grenade. And I think what we need to do is mix it up a little more. And I think the map that we just got that I see is Vertigo. So hopefully we'll do much better on this one.
Yeah, I do agree with you. Honestly, Vertigo is probably one of the more favorites among Faulkner and their bunch. So we're gonna try and do a little better on this one because I've seen some crazy plays from this one, especially from I'm gonna call him Negev Dish.
Yes.
Because
ooh, that's a different one.
Yeah,
that was a different map.
Right, it was. Was it nuclear?
I don't remember what it is, but it probably that I wouldn't be surprised if that's what it's called. It looks like a power plant or a nuclear plant.
Yeah. So this round, I think is going to be a lot more interesting. Honestly, we just need to save up just enough money to give Dish the Negev.
I think they're in knife round right now. Yep. If Michael switches over,
he can't. Because we have that delay, remember?
Oh, well, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It does suck because we have to fill time. Yeah. Nah, we love you guys. So, but yeah, one of the things I'm really hoping to see a little more of is just more, not really aggressiveness, but more like neutral aggressive. So to know when to kind of go in and know like they're going to push here, so we got to defend here. So more strategy, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's something that's going to be a little bit more hard to acquire, especially for each team, because you can't just get a good strategy based off the first game. So this one is going to be definitely a game where you're trying to get a little bit better with ideas, you know? So, yeah. But for the main part, I think that the weapon pick last round was pretty good. I liked most of the weapons that they were using. None of them made me like, man, he shouldn't just be using that. None of them made me do that.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, all the weapon picks were good. We just weren't able to do a whole lot with them.
Was it CornPop who was on that sniper?
Yes.
Because that sniper was going crazy.
All right, we're in the game now.
Yep. All right, and there's knife round. And I believe since we started on counter-terrorist last time, that we're going to start... We started on terrorist last time, which means we're going to be starting
on counter-terrorist this round. I don't know how they've agreed to it, or if they've agreed to anything, but we'll find out in just a second. So it looks like they have agreed to... maybe? Yeah, they're just sitting there. So we will get to be counter-terrorists this round, I think. Yeah.
Yep.
Now we're in pistol round, which will decide who gets in put an advantage first in the... or in the who gets put an advantage in the next round.
Yeah. All right, and I don't see any dualies. I don't see anything going crazy yet, but... yeah. I definitely do see a lot of stuff happening.
Here.
All right, and it looks like they're trying to take a good amount of positions here. There you go. Looks like they're taking a lot of and that's gonna be a plant for them.
Bomb has been planted.
Terrorists win. All right, so Mike is able to get us up on the computer,
and there's our error resolved. Let's go.
Yep.
So now we'll be able to tell you guys more names. Yes. and better call outs, because we were kind of seeing
we were operating on a strange setup.
Hey, we were doing what we could, you know?
Yes. Alright, so we're viewing somebody on the other team right now. And this is Antonio.
Yep.
So we're able... wow, Leo's able to take two of theirs before he goes down.
Love to see it.
But... we're put back in disadvantage fairly early on. Oh, man. Just an unfortunate peek.
Yeah. Not like you do there.
Yeah.
But we're still able to take two kills, and...
we were.
It was not bad. Not bad at all. Definitely comebackable.
Yes, we can definitely come back from two.
That is definitely a word, trust me. Alright, and it looks like they're gonna get...
so it looks like they're gonna run... a couple of SMGs, some ARs, and a pistol, and we are running 3 ARs and 2 SMGs.
Honestly, I've seen a lot of good stuff from Faulkner with SMGs recently.
Yeah.
Dish and CornPop use SMGs pretty well.
Honestly, when I'm playing, I prefer SMGs because of how light they are and how easy it is to get kills with them.
And unfortunately, we do take everyone...
we are down to only CornPop, but I feel like... oh, wow. So he's going to have to defuse the bomb and maybe even kill four people. So this is going to be intense. They kind of had him surrounded on all sides.
He knew he was there. He just didn't know when he was coming in. And unfortunately, he came in right as soon as he turned away.
He did.
Which is a very unfortunate situation. So honestly, playing a little more conservative here and finding better off angles is probably what we're going to need to do.
Yeah. All right, it looks like CornPop is going to run the shotgun, and Leo's also going to run a shotgun.
Heck yeah, I love shotguns.
Yeah, shotguns have got to be one of my favorite weapon classes in this game. Because they're so powerful and they're so just nice to have in close range. Just like that. That's exactly why I love shotguns.
Bro walked into the door and just got deleted.
If you hit him in the chest up close enough, more likely than not, you're getting the kill and you're going to take that. So we leave them with just one person, and I don't think he has the bomb with him.
That's nice.
So if we can if we know where it is, we can hold that point down. So Creed making a risky maneuver there.
And still able to kill him.
Yep, he's able to get the kill.
Just outguns him, basically.
So that puts us a little closer to tying up the game. We're still down 2 points, though.
But hey, at least it helps our economy out, which puts us up with the big boys, you know?
Yeah.
Definitely still winnable. All right.
So everybody stocking up on utilities, except I think Antonio.
That was a lot of bullets he just missed.
Wow, so
I'm surprised.
So what happened there is the other guy threw a grenade and it made a bad bounce and he killed himself with it.
Yikes.
Yeah. However, they're still able to take a lot of kills off of us. All right, CornPop getting one kill.
Definitely can see it happening.
So they've already planted the bomb, and CornPop does have a diffuser kit, so if he's able to get two kills just in time...
Let's see what the captain's able to do here.
So he's able to get one.
He's able to get two.
Let's see, can he defuse the bomb in time? He is.
And that's the captain right there for you.
Yeah.
Pulling up an absolute crazy
CornPop
victory right there.
Pulling up a massive clutch.
Three kills at the end?
Yeah.
I mean, that's beautiful in my book. And that there's why he's the captain.
He's a bad dude.
A very bad dude. That should go on the highlight reel. Goodness. Love to see it. I want to see a three more of those at least tonight.
So that guy has gone there almost every time, and they've practically predicted it every single time.
Which is good.
Yeah, it's really good.
Faulkner is still in the lead. No people have been taken out, and we have taken two of theirs.
Well, we know where their bomb is, and they're not able to get to it because we have it so...
Oof,
oh, man.
Unfortunate.
So I think they're...
He's a
man. So we're able to take that one. So we've just tied up the game, which is really good. When we had a really bad start off in that first round, we're doing much better this round.
It might honestly be the map pick.
Certainly. That very well could be what has caused this just increase in the quality of gameplay. Oh, man.
So it's still 2-2.
Yeah, it is still 2-2. So
very
it's a close
sick.
It is a closer game or closer match.
Looks like both of them are kind of coming back around. on the other player. Oh, that's a sniper. There's another one.
So Creed's able to get a headshot kill through the wall.
That's beautiful.
Unfortunately, Creed's just not able to.
Love to see it. Love to see it on the side.
Yeah, he did. He had a really good play. It's unfortunate Creed wasn't able to get the kill there.
He did pull out that bomb in the middle of that fight, and it kind of slowed him down. He probably could have gotten the kill if he hadn't thrown the bomb.
Yeah.
But you know, mistakes like that happen, and you can't get kind of too bummed out about them, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, he's getting a lot of damage. Oh, he's only on 10
HP. He just took a lot of damage from the fire.
Ooh.
Man. I think that guy hit headshots every single time. He knew exactly where he was going to come out. And he was able to
sneaky with it.
He was able to hit him.
He's right there. No.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he didn't notice him right there, honestly.
I think he knew when he was going to try and flank around. He just wasn't able to get behind the wall fast enough.
Yeah. All right. And that does bring the score from up to 3-5.
So, I don't know if you see what Dish has.
Is that the negative? Please tell me.
It sure is. It is.
Heck yeah. Ladies and gentlemen,
he's most certainly been saving up for that all round, and he's gonna put it to work.
But he's gonna put in the work and the hours.
So he's able to get two kills right off the bat.
Don't let off the trigger. Keep on going.
No, he's definitely gonna run up that mag.
Oh my gosh, it's beautiful. And he's still got 33 bullets in that bad boy. He's locked and loaded. Oh man. Someone get this man to play the game.
Yeah,
I wish this game did play
the games. Yeah, if only they had play the games in this game. So not a whole lot happening. We are down three players, but they're only down two. Wow, Creed able to get the jump on this guy. Unfortunately, he doesn't see him come up behind him.
I barely noticed that guy, honestly.
Who's gonna swap? He's gonna swap off the Negev.
What? Not the Negev.
Well, he's got to go a little bit more mobile with this. He's got to get there in time.
Has the bomb been planted?
The bomb has just been planted. Whoa.
Very good idea to just spray the hallway. Try and keep them out of it. Good job.
He gets right up on him. I don't know if he's going to be able to get the bomb in time, though.
Oh.
Yeah. He tried, he just wasn't able to get it. So that guy does die, and everybody is reset back to pistols.
Very close rounds from Faulkner. I was not expecting into the game to get like this based off the first game, but now that I'm seeing it, I'm very happy that that Faulkner is able to do this like they are, you know?
Yeah.
We can protect it. Whoa! Creed getting absolutely smoked.
So that guy just had a much faster trigger finger, and that's all it was. So they've already, I think they've already planted the bomb, and we're down to just Antonio.
That's unfortunately, Antonio is kind of getting caught off guard.
Yeah, he was at a heavy disadvantage there because they still had their entire team left, and it was just Antonio. It wasn't it wasn't impossible for him to win, but it was very improbable.
Yeah, that's just unfortunate. That's just kind of how it is, though. We just need to kind of put together a better defense and try again. And unfortunately, we kind of fallen down the econ ladder, which is very sad, but...
Dish does have the Negev again.
He does? Oh, it doesn't matter anymore. We've already won. We may lose the round, but we've won the war.
I don't know. We lost that last one, and that wasn't... Oh, man. He goes down really fast.
Unfortunate. You hate to see it, too. Oh, my God.
Well,
gosh,
they're able to take that round very fast.
Seconds. I don't even think I was a minute. I was in seconds. That was such a good round
for
me.
So, we're about to enter halftime.
Goodness. ETS putting up quite a fight. Hate to see it, especially for us, but honestly, if nothing else, this has been really good experience for the boys because we're able to learn from the things we fight against, and we're able to do a lot better next round.
Absolutely. So Creed knew he was going to go up in there.
Right there again. I'm surprised that didn't kill.
So it was. I do believe he was using a pistol, and a pistol takes two headshots to kill. Terrorists
win. That just baffles me how that worked right there.
Yeah. So we've just entered the second half. All they have to do is win four games, and they take it. We'll have to make a serious comeback here.
Oh yeah, and honestly. It's going to be quite a difficult venture, to say the least.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, that's
wow!
Very good grenade.
That already drops Cree down to 26 health.
To get up there, but not able to get it. Oh my
man.
Goodness.
Leo goes down. So, something about these walls, I do believe you can shoot through them. However, you don't know where the other team is, so you would literally be shooting blind into these walls, hoping to get a kill.
Yeah. Also, you do take reduced damage through walls.
Yes.
So, it's not extremely worthwhile, but it is definitely an interesting idea. My real question is, do you get damage pings like when you get hit with your weapon, or is that a no?
I don't remember. When I played, I don't remember if I was using sound. I didn't remember any damage pings.
So that also
maybe you just have to listen for the sound of somebody grunting when they get hit.
Even if you did get oh my god.
Like that?
Gosh.
Yeah.
That was such a clean.
Yeah, so they take that round again and we're now down by 7.
I hate to see it, but you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, things like this happen. Sometimes you just fight a really good team and just knows what they're doing. And all you gotta do is just keep on getting back up and do it again, you know?
Exactly.
You know, that was Einstein's definition of insanity, so, you know, that means we're insane.
Well, that means we'll have to swap it up a little bit. Man.
Oh my gosh.
So he's got that spot locked down with the shotgun.
Faulkner not even able to take one kill at all. Hate to see it.
So we'll have to win 10 rounds in a row if we want to win. So we lose Antonio pretty early on. Man. And two of our guys go down, but CornPop's able to get one kill. So all we have left now is Dish and CornPop.
Yep. You know, the dish had the Negev. I just, of course, but, oh my goodness.
Man. So, and if they win one more round,
just like that,
they win the whole thing.
Yeah. Unfortunately, you hate to see it, but sometimes it is what it is.
Yeah.
I just love watching the animations for the knives in this game. They're so smooth.
I wish that other games like Overwatch had weapon inspects.
At one time, Overwatch did have weapon inspects.
Was that in the Overwatch 1?
That was in Overwatch 1, yeah. They had weapon inspects, and also they had loot crates.
So we're able to get 2 kills with no casualties.
As we should have.
Or taking no casualties ourselves, I should say. Alright, so they're able to kill Leo, but Dish is able to avenge him.
Vengeance is his.
It is. So CornPop.
There we go.
So we're able to take this one. Can we win 9 more? We're gonna find out.
I don't know. I feel like they gave every single person on our team a Negev. I think we had a shot.
Yeah.
But
the thing is, I don't.
Kind of cash.
I was gonna say I don't believe they can all afford it.
I wish. Looks like they're playing a little bit this last match point.
Yes, yeah, they're playing much safer here.
Yeah, trying to find a way in, but it looks like he's locked down.
Ooh, all right, so he's able to get one kill there. So he just saw Creed through the grates, and that's all it was.
Able to get another one. 2-2.
2-3. Alright, now it's 2-2. Can we do anything with it?
My poor eyesight might have been.
Now we're down just to Dish.
Dish can do it. Come on, Dish. It's not just Dish, it's a super Dish.
That's true, he proved that last night. Man, it's really unfortunate.
Unfortunately, that is going to be game. Very close second game, honestly. They were doing, Faulkner was putting up quite a fight in the end.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, this is not enough to get us the victory. So that is going to be the end of the game, and we're going to take a real quick ad, and then we're going to bring in one of the players. We're going to have a small interview, and then, yeah, we'll be right back.
Did you know that 100% of Faulkner's computer science graduates
since 2014 have found jobs
in their fields within 6 months of graduating?
We live in the information age where you either use a computer or you get left behind. Are you ready for your future? Faulkner's computer science program is your gateway to a leading edge career with purpose.
I built church websites, and through the training and instruction that I received from Faulkner, I was able to go right into my career after graduation.
It laid a solid foundation for what you need to know.
At Faulkner, there are many kind and knowledgeable people that are eager to help you prepare for the future.
In the U.S., there are predicted to be over 400,000 job openings each year for computer specialists with median wages well above average. What you learn at Faulkner will give you control of what your future looks like. Our faculty has an average of 16 years of industrial experience and is ready to navigate you to a bright future as a computer scientist. Come join us at Faulkner University. Your future is worth it.
True. training tomorrow's teachers, ministers, and scientists, guiding future business leaders to positively impact our global economy, teaching healthcare professionals to improve patient outcomes, coaching athletes to give their best on and off the field, men and women learning how to succeed wherever their dreams take them. That's Faulkner University. With over 70 undergraduate and graduate degree programs, you'll find your calling, all in a Christian learning environment. Faulkner University. Discover more at faulkner.edu.
And welcome back, and we're here for the in-game interview. We have our boy Antonio, and he was playing for the first time tonight, I do believe. So how'd that feel?
Definitely nerve-wracking. I mean, being in practice versus playing in an actual game versus, you know, other people who know what they're doing, completely different atmosphere. But I mean, I feel like it was manageable. Oh, yeah. For my first time.
Oh yeah, you definitely did really good, especially for your first time. And from what we actually saw a few good plays and a few good things for everyone. And I'm really glad to see that the team's still kind of coming along with the cohesion. There was a lot of communication. And what is one of the things that you think you can do better next time you guys play?
Something that I feel like we can do better is, I guess identifying when to rotate. Like once we kind of realize, you know, they're all stacking one side, just getting better at moving around to there quicker, just so we can try and tackle that.
Gotcha. Makes sense. You guys had a lot of good movement plays, but there was some points in the games where me and Connor could definitely see, like, they could have been there and they would have won so well.
Yeah.
But you can't always be everywhere at once.
Right.
And sometimes that's just the way it goes. But yeah, we're extremely excited to see you, start to play. Me and my boy Connor over there behind the producer seat have been kind of anticipating your arrival for a little while, so we're excited about all the stuff that's going to be happening for the Counter-Strike 2 games upcoming. So what do you think is going to happen in the next one?
Well, hopefully, you know, we'll be able to bounce back kind of from what we had tonight. You know, we kind of started off real slow. Hopefully between now and then, we'll actually be able to bounce back from that, start getting it going a lot quicker, just so we can set the pace right from the start.
Yeah, that's a very good thing to be aiming towards. All right. Well, the score tonight is going to be, again, 2-0. Unfortunately, the Faulkners did lose. The Eagles did lose. Excuse me for that one. And the things we have upcoming for this week is going to be next week, actually, because this week is already over. Man, my brain. So we have an Overwatch 2 game on Tuesday. I do believe we should have a Rocket League game on Monday, if I'm not mistaken. And then on Thursday, we should have two Smash Bros. Games, one for white and one for blue. Definitely stay tuned for that. And then I do believe we should have another Counter-Strike 2 game on Friday. And it's going to be against Grand Valley State University or the Lakers. I'm not sure if that's the SEC team, but I'm definitely looking forward to the awesomeness that's going to happen. So I'm going to give one more special thanks to my, to him, the interview guy. So Antonio, definitely appreciate him coming up here and having the courage to do an interview. And then we're also going to give another special thanks to our producers. It's going to be Mike, and then also to my color commentary, Connor Hagin. And that was all we have for you tonight, and tune in next time for another good game on Faulkner Sports Network.
The preceding broadcast was an official presentation of Faulkner University. It may not be redistributed without the express written consent of the Faulkner University Athletic Department. Regitar USA High Res Arena is sponsored by Regitar USA. The national anthem was performed by the Faulkner University Chorus.
If you would like to learn more about the Faulkner Esports program, visit our official website at FaulknerEagles.com or follow us on Discord, Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, and Instagram for all the latest news and events. Thank you for watching, and soar Eagles!